say that the importance of backing horses that can go well on a wet track. I think the key lead up to this was the Rose Hill Guineas, which was a fortnight ago. We've got some vision of that race. There are three horses that you really want to focus on. You've got Inference, who wins. You've got Impavido, who gets a check at about halfway down the straight and coming through, who cut the corner and veers out to the best going. The horse I want to point out is Inference, though. He was forced to sustain a long sprint here, and he's come home with the fastest last 400, last 200, last 100, and last 50-metre splits of any horse that won on the day. And he's done that over a mile. And if you watch him through the line, he's actually getting further in front of that horse. In my mind, I think he's just a supreme athlete. I think he's got a few lengths on these, and he can definitely handle the wet ground. I'm really keen to be on him. He's my best bet of the day, so it's a max bet on Inference.
The son of So You Think Inference for the Hawks camp. So, the third of the group ones. It's the Rose Hill Guineas for the three-year-olds over 2,000. So behind the barrier for the Rose Hill Guineas, so $600,000, first run in 1910, and this was the first big win in Farlap's illustrious career. He broke some ground here. Let's go to you, Ben, from Crownbet. Who's the mover?
Yeah, punters are very, very keen on Inference. So $330 was available just momentarily. That's certainly gone. $3 the price, and could firm up even further. The favourite here for Inference is the market mover for Crownbet.
Sounds rock solid.
Yeah, my concern with this horse is that he does tend to get back. Well, he did in his last race. He's quite a laid-back kind of horse. He's fairly slow out of the barriers, and there seems to be a bit of a lack of front runners, lack of natural speed. I think Prized Icon might go forward, Harper's Choice, Hollywood Mo maybe, but they're not going to go crazy in front.
I think that's the difference with Inference this time in, because when he got beaten the Norman Robinson in the lead-up to the Vic Derby over race, then he was too antsy early, so it's good to see him just switch off and save some energy.
So where's the best place today? Is it forward, back, or can you win from anywhere?
They seem to be winning from anywhere, don't they?
Middle to the outside. Now we saw that great vision of the last race with Winks and Low Romain. They're really cutting up the inside, so they'll be coming to the middle to the out.
But you can be back in the field, Simon, and still win comfortably.
Getting to the outside, clear room, and I think who set the trend was Darren and Regan Bayless earlier in the day.
Good point. Let's go to Darren Flindell for his call of the Rose Hill Guineas.
What unbelievable. The rain is starting to come down again as the starter is about to release the field here in the Rose Hill Guineas. He does so now. They're off and racing, and Prized Icon and coming through have both jumped well, but Harper's Choice is pushing on from wide out. Land of Choice jumped well right up on the speed, followed by Seabirds looking for a spotter. Then Hollywood Moe's Sizzling Bullet, Sosie Bonner. Well back in the field now as Inference is pinned away on the fence from Ginger Nuts Anaheim, and Impavido has been snagged right back to last of all. Harper's Choice leads her at the mile. Out by a length to coming through, seeing plenty of daylight today in second. Land of Plenty leaders back third, then Prized Icon fourth. Now fifth as Seabirds moves up on the outside. Sizzling Bullet back midfield on the rails. Further back to Sosie Bond, then came Inference. A length further back to Hollywood Mo from Ginger Nuts. Two off to Anaheim, and Impavido last about 10 lengths off the leader, which is Harper's Choice of the 1,200 metres. Out by a length on coming through, Seabirds continues to improve, going to third. Then Land of Plenty from the Victorian Derby winner, Prized Icon. Sosie Bond the outside, a length further back to Sizzling Bullet. Then came the Randwick Guineas winner Inference, the race favourite, well back in the field. From Hollywood Mo, Ginger Nuts is third last, from Impavido, and Anaheim had now got back to last of all. Harper's Choice going along at a good speed, racing to the 800 metres, two lengths clear from Seabirds into a clear second. Then Land of Plenty from coming through, Sosie Bond the outside, further back to Sizzling Bullet, Prized Icon. Looks as though Ginger Nuts is trying to improve. Inference is going forward. Impavido tried to go with him, but he couldn't. Then Anaheim and Hollywood Moe's back last. Harper's Choice, one of the roughies of the field, has skipped well clear, coming around the turn. Land of Plenty on the fence. Ginger Nuts is looping the field with Sosie Bonner, and further back to Inference. Harper's Choice, daring tactics, but here comes the New Zealand Derby winner, Ginger Nuts. He's thrown out the lasso and roping in the leader. Ginger Nuts heads off Harper's Choice, then Sosie Bond in Inference. Ginger Nuts 150 to go. He's way out in front of Inference. Sosie Bond fighting out the miners. Ginger Nuts is getting tired, but he's got the Rose Hill Guineas won. It's Ginger Nuts by two lengths. Nearly a dead heat second. Sosie Bond in Inference. Harper's Choice fourth. Anaheim with late headway. Further back to Hollywood Mo from Impavido. Coming through, drifted back through the field from Sizzling Bullet, then Prized Icon, Land of Plenty, and and C. Burgess weakened in the run to finish back last.
Well done, Cheska. What a rise to fame this horse has had. I mean, basically unknown three starts ago, and he's had the big run into the New Zealand Derby. Harper's Choice gave a mighty sight, didn't he? But Ginger Nuts got around inference, and then he just steamed away, and then some good late closes from the both the So You Think three-year-old.
Yeah, he's a complete rags-to-riches story, this horse. He went through the weanling sale and made $5,000, was then bought at the yearling sale for $42,500. So even then, like, he can't have been a very nice yearling and not particularly fashionably bred because he's making no money. But every time he races, he seems to step up, and he's a proper stayer. I tell you what, the blinkers went on three starts ago, and that's really brought about a lot of improvement in him. And just the way he did it, he was out the back, he had to come wide, he had to sustain the long run. Harper's Choice out in front ran a really good race, but Ginger Nuts, he's a supreme stayer.
I think the winning move was at the 650 when he whipped around Inference and put Tommy Berry in a pocket and then got into that clear space, that clear breathing space and clear ground that we were talking about. He was a little bit wonky coming down the straight there, wasn't he?
Got Jonathan, tired, didn't he?
Yeah, Jonathan Parks won on him two starts back. Opie Bossom jumped on for his last Group 1 win in the New Zealand Derby. Hard fit, dropping back from the 24 to the 2000. Loved the conditions there. Super duper. Anaheim, wait for him to get on a dry track as you head towards the Derby. He was absolutely sensational late. He didn't really handle it. Inference worked away good. Different story if we get on a good track. Last prevail there, the Kiwis can. And I think that makes it the 9 out of the last 8 winners of the Derby have been New Zealand bred. Rosehill Guineas.
8 of the last 9, yeah.
8 of the last 9.
Yeah, Tarzino last year, of course, a Tavistock from there. Now, he was so impressive. So we now work towards the slipper, don't we? And the Magic Millions winner, Hootson's, chasing another multi-million dollar payday.